Okay, no cats in the spark gap assembly area.
Here, you take him.
Today I'm going to show you guys how to hook up a triggered spark gap. You can see here are the main electrodes. That's where the juice flows. And here is the trigger terminal. So we're going to go through those electrical connections. Now I have a piece of bus bar here that I've already drilled a hole in. Just take off the nut and the washer and grab a 3/4 inch wrench. Slip my bus bar on there, washer and nut. Align this so that it looks nice and then tighten that down onto the bus bar. Oh, whoops. Tighten that down onto the bus bar. Okay. And then I have a standard bus bar termination adapter here. Same deal. The only difference here is that the adapter has an anti-corona counterbore on it, and so that means we need to use a socket wrench this time. So I'm going to slip that over the stud, put on my washer and my nut. And then I'm going to grab a socket wrench. Make sure this is going the right direction. And snug up that nut onto the connector. Okay, guys, we've got the main things done here. The two bus bar connectors are hooked up. Can easily have 50 kiloamps go through this switch now. Now we need to deal with the trigger terminal. So I have a wire from my trigger generator that I've already crimped a 1/4 inch ring termination onto. I just take off the nut and the washer on the trigger terminal, slip on my ring termination there. Here I'm going to use two wrenches, two 7/16 wrenches. I'm going to put an open end on the bottom nut. And I'm going to do that to prevent the trigger terminal from rotating inside the spark gap. If I really crank down on this without a wrench on the bottom, I can potentially break something inside the spark gap. And there we go. All the electrical connections are done. Trigger, main electrodes. We're almost ready to use this thing. We just need to hook up the two gas ports, and we'll talk about that next time.